Oh shit, enemies.
Oh, I got killed.
Alright, well, I guess we're starting right out of the gate.
Good lord. You know, last time we did this, I was dropping boxes on an old man. We reload, the old man's gone, and now these skeletons are in the way.
Yeah.
Ooh, a spear. Cool. That looks neat. I want to take that. Come here.
Grab it.
Take it.
Traveler's spear.
I don't know what you are. You have to take it. No, I don't want to put this head.
Right, fine. Throw it. Back. Just throw it. Throw it at him.
Oh, you beat up the head. That's what it is. Alright. That's a weird mechanic.
Oh.
Yeah, that's right. No weapon throw.
Well, damn. Well, I guess this is the revenge old man has on you. He's actually a necromancer the whole time.
He's a foul necromancer the whole time.
Wait.
Wait, what? How did he... Alright, whatever.
He's smacking the head. Oh, that one's body exploded.
The other guy's body just, like, went back together.
Oh, hey, they're gone. Stuff.
Oh, they died. You have to kill them together, then, maybe.
Ooh. Ooh, that's better than your club.
Keeps moving even after it's severed from its body. It's kind of gross to strap it to your back, but it'll do in a pinch. It's old and fragile, so it's quick to break. It's actually a weapon. That's hilarious.
Talk about improv weapons.
Oh, I have so many weapons now I can't carry anymore.
Well, you should probably drop a few.
Well, I don't really know if I want to pick up the squidgy arm.
You should equip to the current one and see how well it works.
Whoa. Why do I suddenly have more inventory space on this screen?
Oh, it's because we're not using the gamepad anymore. Oh, drop the stick.
Oh, why is there a stick here? What's this? Where's drop? Oh, wait, I guess I have to equip it and throw it.
Yep. Oh, no, there it is. Wait, there was the drop option.
Fuck drop. Yeah, fuck that noise. Oh, wait, there's a leaf?
Yeah, remember that was the one that can do wind? That might be useful later.
Yeah, okay. We'll keep that because I can still use it outside of combat and, like, fling wind and stuff. I'm gonna pick up this.
Alright.
Bokoblin arm. Oh, there's sparkles up there.
Now you're encouraged to use your weapons because you have maxed out weapons.
Great.
You can carry.
Now I want to break shit.
Oh, I did a slight bit of spoilers and looked up because it was a good question I had for this game. Well, if everything's degrading, what about the Master Sword? Would the Master Sword break? That seems pretty dumb. And it doesn't break.
Oh, so it makes the Master Sword worth getting by the time you get there, because you've broken a bunch of crappy weapons all the way up to that point.
Like, it recharges. You use up its uses.
Oh, there's an underwater chest.
Yeah, see, that's what I was talking about.
But I don't think I can hold my breath long enough to
get
it.
No, we can't dive. Can't die for
it. I need the metal boots. That's what it is. I need the metal boots. What
bird?
The hell? Oh, shit!
Bats. The eye looks like a bee. Or whatever they're called in Zelda.
Yeah, they're...
Keys.
They're called keys in this one, apparently. I really hope I have, like, a lot of space for this crap. Because... they keep giving me things every time someone... Okay, alright. Thank you. They're clipping. Okay.
Alright, I'm pretty sure the main storyline, you're supposed to go for more of those shrines. Like those little dungeons that you were in.
Oh, I'm starting to move it. Oh, wait! Maybe it's made out of metal. What button did that? Yeah, this one.
Move the cursor towards it. Yeah.
It is made out of metal.
You can lift it up. Should be able to anyway.
That's fun. I don't have magic for this either. I just do it.
Yep.
That's what makes it fun. Can I drop it on the tree?
Probably.
I wonder what would happen if I did that. Alright. Here we go. What turns it off?
B. Dong.
Whoa! It made a cool noise. Did you hear that? It was kind of awesome. Ooh, it's like, what is this?
I don't know.
Ooh, it's probably mud. I really don't want to go in there.
Yeah, that seems like a bad idea.
Link is prone to drowning like a fool. I really don't want to go in there and get drowned.
Oh, wait, there's stuff over there, though. What are those?
Chests.
Two chests. They tease you.
But if I knock them down, they'll fall in the muck.
Yeah. Ooh, you could use the boulder as a way of getting...
I could use magnetism. Oh, God!
Okay, yeah, you definitely...
Okay.
You can't even swim through that. You just sink.
You just sink like a rock. All right, so if I go from this angle over here... the chests and the boulder. I could use them like platforms.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Use the boulder as a platform.
Yeah, platforming. The way it's supposed to be. Not in games where it's not supposed to be platforming. Doom!
Hey, Doom has platforming. It had platforming in the old ones.
It did not. You walked around on a single plane of existence and shot things. There was no up or down.
There were
and if there was, it auto-moved.
Yeah, there you go. Now let go.
Nope.
Oh, it's probably because the ground it's on is slanted. Wait, there was something in the bog. Let go of that, and but keep the magnetism thing on.
Oh, okay. Let's put that over here, then. I don't want to lose it.
Like, go over to the ledge, and then turn on magnet. Yeah, see that in the ground?
Oh, look!
It's too far away for here, anyway.
Interesting. It's probably just a metal boulder, but still. Yeah, it's,
oh,
just
it's a chain.
Boulder.
It's a ball and chain. What's the use of the ball and chain, I wonder?
Oh,
you can climb it.
Oh, okay. Alright, so we're gonna try it.
Oh, try to get the ball in that.
Oh, I get it now.
Maybe you can smash it with itself.
Get it in there without having.
There you go.
What the fuck?
Whoa!
Hey!
Yeah, you found me. You're not
Kitsu? But you can see me? I didn't know your kind could see children of the forest. Well, if you run into Kitsu, please return this to him.
Oh, I guess you gotta click a whole bunch of them.
Oh, and my friends are hiding lots of different places, too. Don't be shy about poking your nose in suspicious places.
So, we should go down that dark alley? Okay.
That appears to be the only thing around here I can really manipulate, other than, obviously, the boxes and the boulder. The boulder has a lot of flat sides on it, so what if I drop the boulder first? Then the box on top of it.
I'll keep it
maybe.
Up. But that's a risky move. Aha! Now it's Jenga time.
Yeah. Oh crap.
Oh
god.
Oh, you're. Okay, it's shallow enough that's not a big deal. Ooh. Haha! Ice arrows. Yep. Ice and fire.
Nice.
Cool. And hot.
Yeah. Right. That was pretty cool platforming. I don't mind that. This is a game that's designed to have puzzles. It's supposed to have puzzles. Supposed to encourage exploration and fun. And just having a grand old time. And that's perfectly fine.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing wrong with that. That's how the game is meant to play.
Oh, yeah, you're supposed to go back up to the top of the tower.
Yeah, they want me to go all the way back up there so I can see the other sights of blah, 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 blah.
You didn't pay attention to the old guy, but if you get into your little iPad thing, you can just fast travel there to the top of the tower.
Oh, can I?
Yep.
What button opens up the iPad?
I think the minus button.
I look at my iPad. Get it?
Yeah.
iPad.
And then you just...
And it's a giant... All right, I'll
then
stop.
You just Skyrim.
fast
with your iPad.
Yes.
Oh, never mind. You disintegrated and went to the heavens. Of course he's up here.
Did you have to leave those skeletons behind, you asshole?
Yeah, that's why he left. He's like, that's what you get for dropping a metal crate on my head, you prick.
Well, I suppose that makes it even.
Yeah,
you guys... did drop a metal crate on his head.
Yeah, I had a little bit of errors on my video editing, and I had actually cut out like a few hours of like having to go to the hospital awkwardly give him flowers while he's on his deathbed, and then this is like 3 months later.
Oh. Alright, well, that makes sense then.
He's doing pretty good for 3 months after a broken neck, though.
And spine. I'd imagine his spine was probably broken. Looks like there's one over there behind the castle, but I can't get over there yet.
That looks awesome.
There's a lava area.
Yeah.
Looks like there's one right there now that wasn't there before.
I didn't even notice one behind the castle.
There wasn't one there. It activated after I went to this one, so it's definitely a activation thing. I see one more. He said there were three. I only see one.
There's one in the woods. If you look in the woods...
What? Where?
And you click in with the right analog stick, you can see the faint orange glow in the tree line somewhere. Because this is as far as I got. I got to where you are right now. And you find the three spots. I couldn't find the third one, and it's the one behind the church. I didn't even see that one.
Well, I only found the one behind the church. I didn't even know that there was other ones.
Yeah, then see, there's
this
the
way.
One.
That one just activated. That wasn't active before, because I was back in that area, remember?
Yeah. If you talk to him, he can help a little.
Oh, God, I hope he doesn't. I guess we'll story some more. What do you want?
Well, you certainly took your time. Did you forget about traveling instantly?
Yeah, I forgot.
If you read instantly. Now then, after I rambled, I wanted you to join me up here so you could use this as a vantage point to search for shrines. Do you know about the scope on your Sheikah slate? Look through it. You can stick a pin anywhere you look to mark them out.
Oh, neat.
The pins on your map serve as a reference point for your travels. Just stick a pin anywhere you're interested in. Just a few tricks I picked up after many, many years in the wild. You may take my advice or leave it. I mean, this beard didn't grow itself. Oh, wait, it did. Go ahead and take a look if you feel inclined to do so at my beard. Or not. Whatever.
Oh, I remember that skull.
Yeah.
It's where you got your badass weapon.
Yeah, it's where that blue goblin is. That badass weapon. Oh my god. Okay. Alright. I think I put it in the right spot.
Mm-hmm.
God only knows. Alright, there's nothing orange over there that I can see from here that's loading.
Oh, there's the church one.
There's another one.
Yeah, I didn't even see that when I was playing.
How many pins can you have?
5, but you only need 3 right now. Because those are the three there's 3 shrines you can get to.
I'm sure that one back there is not
get out of the scope for a sec. And it's over there somewhere. It's over to the right. You've been to that one. But we haven't been to the one in the woods, and you died. Nice.
If only I had a glider.
One little
this ledge on this tower is not very OSHA approved in safety.
No, it's not. I should know. I have to deal with them every day. Let's hope it saved at the top of the tower. And of course it didn't.
Alright, great.
Back to the top of the tower.
Nope. Didn't save my platform. Now I'm gonna drown.
Back to the top of the platform where you can teleport.
Oh, yeah. Fine. Ugh. Means I can listen to the stupid old man again. Rest in peace. Wait, I can travel to my death?
Nope. Just coincidentally right where the tower is. It just shows where you died.
Well, I don't really care where I died. I just know that the damn tower is too freaking tall and I can't see where I'm going. And the ledge doesn't prevent me from walking over the side of it. Which I'm fine with walking over the side of it if I had the ability to glide down to the bottom. Otherwise, I think my character would probably be intelligent enough to not jump off the side of a tower taller than everything in the entire landscape. But I guess I'm not.
I just skipped through his dialogue this time. Yeah, whatever.
Bloody blah blah, freaking bloddity freaking blah. Get your jibber jabbering on the way. Yeah, we know you're a plot device. I get it.
Okay, first one. And second one. And the last one. Somewhere. There's one up there, but I don't think you can get up there yet. Might as well mark it. Screw it.
There's an evil-looking tower up that way, too. He said I needed the Sheik thing to get down. He didn't say anything about getting up. So I should, logically, at some point, be able to climb up there. It looks like the grass goes up that way.
No, that's where... See, there's the cave you came from.
There's a cave there. Yeah, but I could climb up the cliff next to it.
Yep.
Or over here, maybe, and go up the grass over there to get to it.
Yeah, maybe.
Theoretically.
Wait, let's see if there's any other points of interest before you... I could have sworn there was one in that tree line somewhere.
Well, I'll just cut down every single tree over there until I find it.
Okay. Alright, now instead of trying to climb down this, teleport to the cave you started at.
That?
Nope.
Oh, I can teleport to him?
Oh, that's
it
cool.
It shows where he is, never mind. Forest of down. Spirits.
There.
Whee!
Oh, that's a useful tip. Metal weapons can create sparks to light fires.
Also, furthermore, if you light a wooden weapon on fire, it can be used as a torch. Well, that would make the wooden weapon, I'm sure, burn away. Oh god, I'm all the way inside.
That's okay, it's still faster than trying to climb down that tower and then walk all the way here.
Well, that's true.
Well, you say it yourself, this game's about exploration. Alright, well, since we're that close to that one shrine, why don't we try to climb up the ledge and get to it?
Alright, so this ledge, I'm thinking, is probably much taller than my piss-poor stamina can handle. Oh, sparkles.
No, don't grab them. Hey, mushrooms.
Shrooms.
Those are actually, you know, health. I always need help. You know, you should try climbing it. If you can't make it, then whatever.
Try a smaller cliff side. There's this cliff side over here.
Oh, right here. You can start slightly up.
Yeah. Didn't want to use my really good weapon for this, just in case. You know, you get up there and someone tries to beat you. Oh boy.
You got this.
It's a ledge. Looks like a ledge. Probably isn't, though.
Oh, if you go. Yeah.
Oh, that was it right there. You have to stop for a second. I got this now.
Yeah, easy. You could have made that full thing.
Possibly, but I didn't know how the stamina drain worked, and I really didn't want to mess with it. Stamina drain thing could be like a real pain in the ass.
Okay, that is way further away than we thought.
Not too much.
Oh, hey, there's a bridge down
there. Yeah.
We should head that way. Oh, wait, there's an outpost over here, too.
Goblin outpost. I could probably swim that.
No.
I don't know if it's cold water, though. I might take damage or freeze to death or something.
Dude, those little puddles I could almost drown in, so, when I was playing.
Temperature is dangerously low. Find warmth soon and you'll take damage. Oh.
Hey, warmth.
Never mind, then. Guess I can't go that way until I have warmer clothes.
Well, we'll find one shrine one
guess
way or another.
Guess I'll just have to kill.
And we are up high, and we're in a different perspective on the map.
Oops. Right.
So. What?
Thank you, tree.
Let your club be badly damaged. You don't care.
Oh no, my club I stole from one of these tarred scarfs is freaking broke.
I still think that's a pretty annoying mechanic. How'd they lose sight of it?
Shit.
Just switch out.
Oh, this spear sucks.
Try the spear. It has better durability.
Oh, does it?
Yeah, it's made of metal.
Nice. Whoa, shoot, that's effective. Oh my god, look at that.
Oh, wow. But it's two-handed. You can't use your shield.
Oh, who cares? I don't need my freaking shield if I can shank them that quickly. Look at that.
Ooh, can you harvest that?
Can I eat
that?
The meat? Oh, I can.
Ooh, a heart and a half.
I can stand in the open flame, too.
That hurts you.
No, it didn't. I didn't think
you were staying there too long. You got plenty of wood, so...
Yeah.
Wait. Pull out a club and smack the fire with the club. You might have warmth. Ooh, that
look,
you could use.
I can sit at the fire.
Oh, that's if it's nighttime or something.
I'll wait till morning.
Okay. But you should use one of their clubs as torches, maybe not as weapons.
Oh, that's probably why their torches are like that, or why their clubs are everywhere.
Like, switch to the club and smack the fire. See if it, like, catches on fire.
I guess I'm not really out of anything if I lose it.
Yeah.
Alright, so let's go over here to our weapons. And let's use this.
I mean, it's not like we're probably gonna run into more right down the road anyway. That'll have more clubs. There. Perfect.
Yep.
Look
it's
at that,
torch.
He holds it up like a torch. All right.
How long does it burn, I wonder?
We'll see soon
does
enough.
Does it show a durability somewhere that I can see?
No, but it shows the time of day and
look, it shows the temperature. There's a temperature gauge.
There is?
Yeah, over to the right. Right above the sound gauge.
Right above the
time.
It
shows me running.
Oh, yeah. I thought that was like a gas thing. It looks like gas. Like F for fuel.
I think if I went that way, it would be like, hey.
Oh, there's more guys over there.
Yeah. I'm gonna have to go kill them.
Whoa. Oh, getting towards the skyship, kind of. Oh, you should shoot him with the bow. You remember how to do that?
Is it?
Right trigger. You hold right trigger, pull it out, and then you let go, like, right trigger to release the arrow.
Oh gosh!
Oh, jeez. Wait, light his outpost on fire.
Yeah.
No! Whoa, hey, look at you going all stealthy.
Well, I need a different weapon if I'm gonna shank him.
Use the bony arm, why not? Screw
yeah,
it.
Let's slap him with his dead friend's arm.
He's wiggle.
Like, still wiggles around on your back. That's disgusting.
Oh, he sees you. He sees you.
Ah, shit. Nope. Nope.
That's screwed.
Nope.
Oh,
oh
big
God,
skin.
What the hell? Oh, oh, damn. Oh, no, no, no. That's not cool.
No, don't get in range of the bow. Stay close to the post so he can't shoot you.
I don't want that. Oh,
smack him. Smack him. Oh, wow, that thing does have low durability.
Oh, God, it's broke already.
No, get the stick guy. He seems to be the biggest threat. Grab it. Oh, that's a
fucking spear.
That thing's shit. That is the poopiest weapon ever.
Darn that if it breaks.
Oh. Grab it.
Give me that.
Haha.
Give me that.
Well, you don't need to change shields just yet. Weapon. Weapon.
It's just breaking with the club. Who cares? They're a dime a dozen.
Yep.
But they don't want to break the good stuff. Can't pick up your weapon, though, so you're just going to have to not drop weapons anymore.
Get the bow guy. He's still there.
I got him. Now, after we kill these guys, I'm going to attempt to break him. Like, break the towers of fire just to see if it's possible.
Oh.
There's a mob chest up here.
Might as well go get it.
I will right after I loot this corpse. Get arrows. Gotta get those arrows every time you see them. Ooh, iron boxes. Nice. I could have used my iron box thing.
In the chest. Amber, a fossilized resin with a caramel-esque
sheen to it. It has been valued as a component in decorations and crafting since ancient times. Oh, I could probably use it for making stuff. Neat. Alright, so I'm gonna attempt to light my stick on fire.
Oh, that works.
And then light the outpost on fire. So let's see if I can do that.
Eh? Smack it. Attack.
Nope. It's not flammable. Alright, so we know that I can go like this.
Alright.
Let the brush catch fire.
We'll go explore the snowy tundra.
God, I hope I didn't hurt myself first then. I think I did.
We'll try to go towards the snowy tundra.
Light the boxes.
Yes,
God! The boxes.
Oh no, your shield. Your shield.
Oh God, my shield. Oh, my shield broke.
Alright, well. We'll
got an extra shield. Oh look!
Oh, they had
boiled
apples. Baked apples.
Well, they're baked now. They weren't baked before.
Well, we'll...
just gonna light the forest on fire here, because...
we'll continue exploring next time.
Yeah, this looks like a good spot here. Just wait for all these trees to burn down. Fire, fire, fire.
Oh. Something hurt you.
Ow. Oh, God, I'm almost dead. All right, lighting things on fire is dangerous.